Hello. In this video, we will take a quick overview of the cardiovascular system. We will see some basic points about the heart and blood vessels. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. The cardiovascular system is composed of heart and blood vessels. Heart pumps blood into the blood vessels. Blood vessels circulate the blood throughout the body. The blood brings oxygen and nutrients to the tissues and removes carbon dioxide and other metabolic waste products. Thus, the main function of the cardiovascular system is to supply nutrients and remove waste products from the peripheral tissues. Apart from that, this system also participates in the regulation of body temperature, maintenance of fluid balance, and adjustment of oxygen and nutrient supply in changing physiological states. Now let's go into more detail about the heart. It is made up of four chambers, two atria and two ventricles. The heart is also referred to as a dual pump because four chambers make two separate pumps in series. The right atrium and right ventricle makes one pump, sometimes also referred to as the right heart. It receives venous blood from the vena cava and propels it towards the lungs. Left atrium and left ventricle makes the other pump, also called left heart. It receives blood from the lungs and propels it to all other tissues of the body. So these were the chambers. Now let's talk about valves. Flow of blood through the heart is unidirectional. That is, it flows in one specific direction. The unidirectional flow is achieved with the help of flap valves. When the blood tends to flow back at any level, the respective valve closes and prevents the backflow. So the blood flows only in one direction. There are four valves in the heart. Two valves are in between atria and ventricles, called atrioventricular valves. Left atrioventricular valve is otherwise known as mitral valve or bicuspid valve. It is made up of two cusps. Right atrioventricular valve is known as tricuspid valve and it is formed by three cusps. The other two valves are present between ventricles and major arteries. The valve between the right ventricle and pulmonary artery is called the pulmonary valve, and the valve between the left ventricle and the systemic aorta is called the aortic valve. They both are made up of three flaps. Because of their half moon-like shape, they are also called semilunar valves. So that was the heart. Now let's see some more detail about blood vessels. The circulatory system is composed of vessels arranged in series and in parallel. Here we broadly have arteries, capillaries, and veins. Arterial system comprises the aorta, arteries, and arterioles. As we go from the aorta to the periphery, the lumen gets smaller and resistance increases. This resistance reaches a maximum level in the arterioles. So the arterioles are also referred to as resistance vessels. Constriction and dilatation of arterioles and small arteries allows regulation of tissue blood flow and also helps in control of arterial blood pressure. So these were arteries. Then many capillaries arise from each arteriole. Due to their large size, the total cross-section area of the capillary bed is very large. As a result, blood flow velocity becomes quite slow in the capillaries. Also, the wall of the capillaries is only one cell thick. The slow blood flow and thin wall are ideal for exchange of diffusible substances between blood and tissue. And that's the exact function of capillaries, the exchange of substances. From capillaries, the venous system starts. It includes venules, veins, and vena cavae. As we go from the capillaries to the heart, the diameter of veins increases. Veins hold a large quantity of blood and hence they are also called capacitance vessels. So these were blood vessels. As this video is just for introduction, I have kept the details minimum. For more details, watch a separate video on the physical properties of blood vessels. Now let's talk about the systemic and pulmonary division of the circulation. Systemic circulation is also known as greater circulation. In this, oxygenated blood is pumped from the left ventricle. It passes through the arterial system and reaches the tissues. At the capillaries, exchange of various substances between the blood and the tissue takes place. After exchange, blood enters the venous system and returns to the right atrium. Thus, in systemic circulation, oxygenated blood is supplied from heart to tissues and deoxygenated blood returns to the heart through veins. Then we have pulmonary circulation. It is also called laser circulation. Here, blood is pumped from the right ventricle to the lungs through the pulmonary artery. Exchange of gases occurs between blood and the alveoli of the lungs at pulmonary capillaries. Oxygenated blood then returns to the left atrium through the pulmonary veins. Thus, in pulmonary circulation, the blood gets oxygenated in the lungs. The blood then enters the systemic circulation again, and the cycle is repeated. So that is all the basics about the cardiovascular system. Now let's have a quick summary. The cardiovascular system is composed of the heart and blood vessels. The heart has four chambers, two atria and two ventricles. The four chambers make two pumps, right heart and left heart. The blood flow in the heart is kept unidirectional with help of one-way valves. The blood vessels circulate the blood. Arteries take blood from the heart to other organs. At capillaries, exchange of substances takes place, and veins take the blood back to the heart. In the systemic circulation, oxygen is delivered to the peripheral tissues, and in pulmonary circulation, the blood gets oxygenated in lungs. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.